He was convicted last Thursday of maintaining a drug manufacturing facility. I mean, that sounds so serious. Like, this guy is some Colombian drug lord. I mean, it sounds like something in a movie. But it's real. And he's facing potentially 20 years behind bars. Now, this is a 54-year-old man. He was a wedding photographer. This happened back in 2012. He didn't take a plea. He represented himself. He made an awful lot of mistakes. You know, mainly because when you represent yourself, you're at a loss with the system and the process. I mean, this is, you know, the justice system is tough. I have been talking about also that the jury, I think, had they been instructed that they had the power to not only judge the facts in the case, but also the law, as per the New Jersey Constitution, Article 1, Section 6, judge the facts and the law. Essentially backing up this idea of jury nullification, where a jury of your peers can decide that the law is too onerous and draconian, and they can throw it out. That didn't happen. That's another issue. But I'm joined now by Mary Lou Zahn. Mary Lou, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Now, you are John Podido's girlfriend.
Yes, yes. We've been together for 14 years.
Wow. How are you doing? First of all,
I'm shaking like a leaf. I couldn't even get in touch with John last night. You know, for some reason, these phone calls, they're exorbitant and they don't work. And John's he's so upset at being in prison. He can't be locked up. And he says criminals, nobody in there. You know, they think it's a joke that he's, the other inmates think it's a joke that he's in there.
Right. Like the real criminals. Right, yeah, the people who are committing heinous crimes, he's locked up. It's unbelievable.
You know, he has twice the sentence of any of them. You know, and well, that's because it's a class A felony. It's up there with aggravated rape, assault, murder. You know, this growing thing. You know, marijuana seeds grow by themselves. He didn't even clear the woods. It's absurd. And what you said about. The judge did mention you can judge the law, but that was in the back breath. He did like 20 minutes on the rules to the jury before they went in. He did mention that, but you could hardly hear it. Now, the thing about this is that we had been working on this case for so long, and the reason he decided to go to a jury trial was because that was how alcohol prohibition was lifted. It wasn't lifted. Now, you know what goes on in politics. Nothing gets done. And the reason alcohol prohibition was lifted was because people went to jury trials.
You're right. Mary Lou, I've been talking about that. This jury nullification was huge in the 20s, fighting prohibition. And whether people agree with it or not, it also was invoked with the Dr. Kevorkian trials as well. So juries have a lot more power than people think. I don't know that if the prosecutor, though, has the power to essentially handpick a jury, that you're going to make much progress. Mary Lou, thanks for staying with me on New Jersey 101.5.
Sure. This is like, yeah, very important to me. You know, and I want to address that marijuana is, they keep mentioning it's a dangerous, they must have mentioned it over hundreds of times during the trial, that it's a dangerous substance. It's not a dangerous substance. Let me tell you, I've been using marijuana responsibly for 40 years, and I started when I was 16, and I graduated high school with high honors, a 98 average, and a Regents scholarship. I received 100% on my geometry Regents, a 98 on my trigonometry, and a 99 on algebra. You know, and the thing is, over 50% of the population agrees that marijuana should be legalized. It should be regulated just the way that alcohol is.
Well, let me ask you this, Mary Lou. Let me ask you this more on a personal level, because I don't disagree with you now. I think that, okay. And I've come full circle on this. I went through a phase younger thinking all drugs should be legal. Then I had kids,
right.
I thought, okay, we got to do something. I have often said that this so-called gateway drug, anything can be a gateway drug. Anything. It isn't about the substance as much as it is about the personality and the addictive nature that some people have. So there's
right,
a much broader issue at play here. But here's my question.
That's codependence.
How are
people
you? Bring me into how are you dealing with this? Because, you know, you're so he's 54.
I'm now, 56.
And you're 50, so you're talking about the next 20 years of your life. This
I
is
can't.
The
he's everything. I work full time in a hospital. I take care of HIV patients. I run a health and fitness gym on the top inpatient psychiatric unit in the country. I teach balance training to older adults. I teach Tai Chi for arthritis. I teach Tai Chi in the MICA unit. It's an inpatient mentally ill chemical abusers unit. I work, and, you know, I also teach watercolor.
Mary Lou, did you at any point suggest to John that he take a plea?
Well, we talked about it a lot. I was scared, but, I wanted to, he thought that this was the right thing. He's doing it for other people more than he's even doing it for himself, because he's the only one who could sort of do this. He has no prior criminal record. He's never done anything violent. He owns nothing. He rents a tiny little apartment. His car has over 300,000 miles on it. He has no bank accounts. The reason I'm with him is because he's such a wonderful person. He's unique. He rubs my feet every night. You know, for an hour without me even asking, he makes me dinner. I make him dinner. We go fishing. We love to fish. He's the best fishing partner ever. He watches football with me, and I watch hockey with him. He's just, I had to back him up on this because I believe he's right. You know, we can't be sending people to jail for this. It's so wrong. It's so wrong, you know, and even people who, you know, marijuana.
What
not
kind
for
of what kind of reaction are you having among your friends and family? Are people shaking their heads, saying, "Ah, so stupid. Should have had a lawyer. Should have taken a plea." Or are people saying, "Good for him. He's the champion of many people that don't have a voice."
Well, that's a hard one. You know, we don't want to. He's in jail now, and he's suffering a lot.
But I'm saying, what are people reacting in terms of people you're close to? Are they shaking their head at you and saying you guys are wrong and this was stupid and you knew it was illegal? Or are they backing you up and saying good for him and we're with him and we're going to contribute to the defense fund?
Well, people are saying that he was right and he did the right thing and we're backing him up 100%.
Okay.
You know, everybody needs to back him up 100%. It's the only way that we're going to get out of this and we're going to stop this from happening to other good people. You know, if the populace stands behind him and speaks up, now everyone's afraid because it's still illegal. They're afraid they'll get in trouble. But First Amendment, we have the right, more than 50% of the population. His boss, who doesn't use marijuana in any way, got up on the stand and spoke about he would trust his life with
now,
John.
Mary Lou, are you going to go see him? Are you going to see him this week? And if you are, tell him I want to talk to him. And I want to have him call in. So if you can talk to him, let me know. I want to have John on the show, and I want our listeners to hear him and hear it from his perspective. And first of all, see how he's doing. Know that I really do sympathize with the cause here. I think that it's changing a lot of minds. I think it is absolutely an egregious miscarriage of justice that a man could face 20 years in prison when you've got rapists and murderers doing less. So if the way to solve that is either an instruction to the jury on jury nullification, or if it's to legalize marijuana across the board, something's got to be done. Mary Lou, you guys are in our thoughts and prayers. You hang in there. Thank you for calling New Jersey 101.5. And stay on the line and talk to Kira and make sure that we can arrange to have John call in this week or next. Okay? Thanks, Mary Lou.